These cars aren't just fun. They're the greatest military power in the world and the fastest production military cars on the planet. Have a glance at the most technologically advanced vehicles that make humanity proud. Enjoy, and don't forget to follow. Ghost. Ghost seems like the transport vessel that Darth Vader uses, and it's as futuristic as it gets. Ghost is a transport ship whose main goal is stealth. This craft works by hydroplaning over water via side fins that act as a support and lift the rest of the hull out of the water. This lift separates the hull from the water, which allows the Ghost to reduce friction significantly, saving fuel and gaining speed. The engines are located at the bottom of the side fins. The turboshaft engines provide nearly 2,000 horsepower. Almost all components needed to run the ship are submerged in the water. This provides critical parts with the natural protection of the water. The top speed achieved by this monster is nearly 50 knots or 90 kilometers per hour. The speed of an average ship on water is 20 to 25 knots or 46 kilometers per hour. 2011 Paramount Group Marauder. If you want the closest thing to a tank on wheels to roam the streets, the Marauder is your best bet. The 18-ton tank on wheels is the brainchild of the people at the Paramount Group in South Africa. The Marauder has a maximum speed of 120 kilometers per hour, which might not seem like much until you consider its massive weight. If you plan to travel to a faraway place and you're worrying about the fuel, the Marauder is your friend. The fuel tank capacity of this monster is enough to travel 500 kilometers. Also, the vehicle provides a Rolls-Royce level of comfort for the passengers due to its incredible climate control system, which can regulate the temperature between plus 55 degrees to minus 32 degrees. What I would give to drive one of these. Autocar Cobra. Each day, we advance in terms of technology, and as a result, we get to see some weird and interesting vehicles. These technological advances are also found in the military, where the capabilities of vehicles determine the tide of war. One such marvel of technology and innovation is the Autocar Cobra. This fighting machine is capable of moving on land and sea, making it a true fighting amphibious vehicle. This vehicle is perfect for the average lazy Joe like me to fish without even having to set foot outside. However, the role of this machine is far more important than what I had in mind. The Cobra can switch roles according to need, just like the Ocelot. The armament on the Cobra is a 12.7mm machine gun and a cannon that can pierce the armor of just about any other fighting vehicle. Flip mode. Usually, the roles of vehicles in the military dictate the shape, size, and looks of the vehicles. The flip mode is the only vehicle that can actually be used as a daily driver since it looks like a dune buggy. The flip mode shares much of the aspects of a dune buggy because it's light, agile, and versatile. The flip mode provides the standard armor protection to the soldiers inside as any other vehicle does. You might be wondering what the name flip mode means. Let me ease your tension. The vehicle has the ability to flip with the help of roll bars on the side, so you can be confident that it'll never roll over in a sticky situation. Viper Commander. This 16-foot long, 6-foot tall monster is designed with only one goal in mind, to protect anyone inside it. And boy, can this beast hold a lot of people. The Viper Commander is as cool as its name. This beast weighs over 3 tons and can hold up to 15 passengers. The hull of the Viper is shaped in a V that deflects the blast to the sides so the impact isn't transmitted to passengers. In terms of protection, this vehicle is capable of taking on mines and IEDs, so you can be at peace when inside this monster. The name Viper Commander sounds like the name you would give to a starship in outer space, and if this vehicle was fixed with 2-star engines, it would pass for a spaceship too. 2015 Zeal Punisher. You might have seen videos on YouTube or any other website about what happens in Russia. The people there go the extra mile to make things more interesting. Say hello to Russian's answer to the American Humvee. The Zeal Punisher is a massive armored monster truck used to protect soldiers from the hazards of battle. This 26-ton monster is capable of achieving speeds of over 90 miles per hour, making it quite possibly the fastest armored personnel carrier in the world. The engine powering this mammoth is a 730 horsepower V8 engine, which ensures that if things start to go south, it's possible to bring soldiers out of harm. Would you want to drive this car if you had the chance? I'd volunteer to drive this vehicle in a heartbeat. BvS-10 Viking. Vikings were a breed of Scandinavian fighters that had only one thing in mind: war. Now, there are no signs of the Viking, but something more high-tech has taken that name. Introducing the BvS-10 Viking. This beast is cool beyond words. Usually, vehicles have only a single chassis in which all passengers are accommodated, but this beast is on a whole other level, with the addition of a second chassis that follows it around. The company that's responsible for this beast is the Hägglunds. The beast is 2.2 meters in length, the front car weighs in at 5 tons, and the rear vehicle is 2.1 meters and is a whopping 3.5 tons, which brings us to a total of nearly 8 tons. Due to its tracks, the Viking can go nearly anywhere on Earth. Humvee. If you're on the battlefield with incoming fire from all sides, you might have to put your trust in a vehicle that's proven itself in combat. The Humvee is a standard vehicle used by soldiers in the American military, as it has a perfect track record of being fast, protective, and extremely reliable in sticky situations. The actual name of the Humvee is HMMWV, which stands for High Mobility Multipurpose Wheeled Vehicle, which has enough description in the name to understand the car's potential. The vehicle saw extensive action in the Middle East and is still used by the military today. The Humvee has all-wheel drive and disc brakes for each tire to provide the appropriate stopping distance. It also has independent suspension for the wheels, so the Humvee can undertake rough terrain on the battlefield. Willys MV Jeep. The Willy Jeep was inducted into the Army during the Second World War. As the Americans were in a rush to compete in the war, a requirement of a light, versatile, and reliable vehicle arose. Multiple companies invented different vehicles in all shapes and sizes, but the Willy Jeep was chosen because it was cheap, robust, and reliable, ideal for the rough European terrain. You might have seen this vehicle in movies due to the distinct features that set it apart. The long slotted grille in the front, the VW Beetle-like bumper in the front, and the round bug-eyed headlights make it stand out. The only drawback is the stiff suspension that made it extremely uncomfortable to drive. Would you drive this if you had the chance? M1 Abrams. To be honest, I would drive anything that has an engine in it, so driving a tank is probably the most awesome thing I could do. Imagine driving a 60-ton vehicle with a jet-powered engine. Yes, the M1 Abrams is what I'm talking about. This fighting vehicle is equipped to take on any enemy it faces, and the 1,200 horsepower gas turbine engine ensures it can roll around on any type of terrain it finds itself in. The 1,200 horsepower engine can bring this 60-ton vehicle to a top speed of 45 miles per hour. Even though the engine is fun to have while driving around, what's even more fun is the 120mm main gun that's attached to the turret. It would be a dream come true if I ever got to drive one, and I'm pretty sure it would be a dream come true for you as well. Sherman Tank. Even though World War II was the most tragic thing that could happen to the human race, the tank was the most useful and powerful weapon at the time, and every country was trying to improve it. The Sherman tank is one such example of this technology. The Sherman tank was commissioned in the military in World War II when the need for a small, agile, and powerful tank was needed to fight the Germans. The M4 Sherman was the answer, as it checked all the boxes. The Sherman was lighter and cheaper to produce than its counterparts, so it was much faster and much more agile. The Sherman is a capable tank on rough terrain, and it would be an honor to drive such a magnificent piece of machinery.